I'm passionate about finding and buying quality pre-loved items from charity shops and car boot sales that I later resell on the selling platform eBay to make a profit. My aim is to post update videos that show you my Magpie finds, what I initially paid for them and what they actually sold for, and how much profit I made after the initial costs, postage and packaging, and eBay selling fees. I will share any helpful tips I have gained, as well as any pitfalls I have made to help you along the way too. My Magpie finds, from the 1st of April to the 29th of July, 2022. My objectives: buy quality used items in a very good condition, with a maximum customer base and items that will be easy to post. Always aim to sell your item for 5 times what you paid for it initially. Only visit local towns charity shops and or car boot sales for 1 outing per week. Keep up with listings and don't hoard. On my first eBay sale, invest all profit back into stock to resell. Always keep back some profit from future sales to reinvest. Don't buy any packaging materials except for tape. Recycle packaging from home. Make sure you account for tape and label use in your postage and packaging price. Only replenish my stock if I have the money to do so from my eBay profit. Aim to flip a profit within a month of listing the item on eBay. I started my charity shop flips with a Norge wool coat. This is a vintage 100% wool green coat and a UK size 14. I purchased this for £1 on a clearance sale rail. I sold this coat on eBay, inclusive of postage and packaging, for £25.50. My profit after fees was £14.64, which I then reinvested into other items. My next purchase was of a Made in Britain 1950s handbag. I purchased this for £5. I was able to sell it within a couple of weeks on eBay for £25.99, inclusive of postage and packaging. This gave me a profit of £9.69 after fees. This vintage Winsmore two-piece suit in beige with a beautiful bow detail was a UK size 16. I purchased this for £7 from a charity shop. I was able to sell it within the month for £28.99 on eBay, inclusive of postage and packaging. My profit after fees was £12.42. I was very excited to find these lovesome leather riding boots. They are quality leather made in England and was a UK size 9. I purchased these for £12. I was able to sell them on eBay within a couple of weeks for £69.99, making me a huge profit of £42.74 after fees. I spotted this small mid-century abstract brutalist brooch, which doubled up as a dried posy holder, for £3.50. I was able to sell it within a couple of days on eBay for £15, making me a quick profit of £7.83 after fees. This 1980s Jane Shilton faux leather blue handbag with gold tone hardware was purchased for £3 from a charity shop. This took a while to sell, approaching the month point, but I managed to sell it for £17.98 inclusive of postage and packaging, making me a profit of £8.43 after fees. I was very excited to spot another pair of leather riding boots in the charity shop. They were quite tatty and I had to give them a good clean up. They were UK size 9 and came with some boot shapers and wooden lasts. I purchased these for £10. And I was able to sell them within the month for £48.99, inclusive of postage and packaging, giving me a profit of £25.25. At a car boot sale, I found these Regent's Chelsea boots. They're an oxblood colour, and they were on the small size at a UK size 7. I purchased these for £5. They did have a small flaw in the leather and I managed to sell them within a couple of weeks for £14.99, making me a small profit after fees of £5.76. As you can see on the photograph, I always point out any flaws for the customer and list them in my eBay listing. Again, at a car boot sale, I was ecstatic to find these quality leather riding boots in a UK size 9. I was even more pleased when I spotted they were only £5. I put them on eBay and within just a few days I was able to sell them for £65.50 inclusive of postage and packaging, making me a huge profit of £51.75 after fees. Again at a car boot sale, I spotted this brass shoehorn with a swan's head and some wooden shoe lasts. I purchased these for £4. I sold them on eBay within a couple of weeks for £17.50. My profit after fees was £8.44. At a local yard sale, I spotted a genuine mulberry leather clutch bag. I noticed that its strap was missing, but I was able to purchase it for £2.50. I was able to sell it on eBay within a couple of hours for £59.99, inclusive of postage and packaging, making me a huge profit of £50.94. This vintage costume brooch bundle I was able to purchase for £7 from the yard sale. I've split them down to sell them individually, and all of them have sold apart from three. I was able to sell them for £24.25, making me a profit after fees of £16.53, still with three to sell. This vintage St. Michael tweed style blazer is made in England of pure new wool. I spotted this in a charity shop for £6.50. I popped it on eBay and it sold overnight for £29.98, making me a quick profit of £22.97. Again, I spotted this brooch in a charity shop. It's large amber glass with a really beautiful gold tone and roll clasp to it. I purchased this for £1.50. It took a while to sell. I was surprised because it was large in size. I ended up taking an offer and selling it for £6.49, inclusive of postage and packaging. I only had a small profit of £2.35. This Burton's cashmere and wool blend sporting jacket was purchased from a charity shop for £4. It took a while to sell, possibly because it was the wrong time of year to be thinking of cashmere. I took an offer for £18.99 for it to keep within my month's flipping. I gained a small profit of £8.31. This vintage straw boater is from the 1920s and is made by England by the brand Olney. I spotted this in a charity shop for £10. I was able to sell it on eBay within a couple of weeks due to the Henley Regatta for £29.50. Profit after fees was £15.10. This Orvis fleece is lightweight and in a country style in a UK extra large. I spotted this in the charity shop for £7. I was a little unsure as to whether I could sell it due to the time of year, but it was lightweight. I was able to sell it within a couple of weeks for £34.98, making me a good healthy profit of £20 and a penny. This Cupra fur pelt hat is made in Australia. I purchased it for £10 from a charity shop and I was able to sell it within my month's target for £35.99, making me a profit of £14.95 after fees. I was excited to spot these riding boots in a charity shop. When I picked them up, I felt that they weren't leather, but they were actually rubber. They're fully lined and they're from the Loveson brand. I purchased them for £8 and I was able to sell them within a couple of days on eBay for £40.98, inclusive of postage and packaging, making me a quick and healthy profit of £26.67 after fees. Again, I spotted this Wright cowboy hat, 10 times quality and custom made. It was a very tiny size, but it was £10 from a charity shop and I was able to sell it within the month for £56.99, giving me a healthy profit of £33.47 after fees. This vintage St. Michael Linen Blend blazer again was a charity shop find. I purchased it for £6 and it took a while to sell. I ended up pushing past my month target and ended up taking an offer for it within 6 weeks of listing for £14.99. I made a profit of £5.14. I expected to get more for this when I purchased it, but a profit's a profit. These Clark's Flex Light shoes were in a very good condition in the charity shop. They were a good size at UK 9. I purchased these for £4.50 and was able to sell them within a couple of weeks on eBay for £16.99, inclusive of postage and packaging, giving me a profit of £7.49 after fees. I was surprised to see this Ted Baker large tote handbag in the charity shop. I purchased it for a really good price of £12.50. I was able to sell it on eBay within the month for £65.50, inclusive of postage and packaging, making me a healthy profit of £36.38 after fees. I purchased two items, but I'm not listing them until the autumn to maximise my selling. One of them is a Jack and Wills wax jacket, which I purchased from a car boot for £15, and a barber jumper for £3. So I've invested a total price of £18. I'm happy to hold these two items, but I'm careful not to hoard anything else now. Has there been any fails? Yes, four items. After my success of selling the vintage St. Michael wool blazer in the tweed style, I picked up this one. Again, it's made in England of pure new wool. It has been for sale all this time, and I've reduced it to clear at £12.50 plus postage and packaging. I purchased it for £7.99. I do not want to sell it for any less than that, otherwise I will go into a negative profit margin. To date, it's unsold. I picked up a Jane Shilton shoulder bag. I have sold it and used an eBay previously sold for template for a similar bag by Jane Shilton. I didn't check through all the item specifics properly and sold it as a genuine leather bag rather than a faux leather. After a month, the customer contacted me as the faux leather started to flake off the bag and the customer asked for a full refund, which I promptly agreed to. I was also very grateful that I didn't receive any negative feedback. My initial purchase price was £2, and after losing the £2 and my postage and packaging costs, I was in a negative of £6.99. But I've used this as a warning and a lesson for us all to really check the previously sold templates that you use on eBay. And just because somebody else has used it and it's sold, it doesn't mean that all the item specifics are fact for that item. These V12 Colt work boots were purchased from a charity shop for £4.50. When you look at them at brand new prices, they're anywhere between £45 to £75. I expected to be able to make a profit on these, but I had zero interest. I had to put them to reduce to clear at £9.99 plus postage and packaging, and they were still unsold. I've managed to give them away to someone who was needing them, as they had a hole in their work boot, and I'd rather them be of use than be sat in my cupboard waiting for a sale. I purchased a vintage Harris tweed blazer from the yard sale. I didn't check it properly and found it to be faulty. I was in a dark garage and was pressured with other people around me, so it was my own fault. I decided to list it on eBay with all its flaws made clear to a customer rather than sending it to landfill. I accepted an offer for £7.50 for it plus postage and packaging. My initial purchase price was £5. I actually made a loss of £2 after fees. But again, somebody else is using it rather than it going straight to landfill. April to July 2022, total take-home profits. I had a total initial spend of £182.49. My incoming sales profit after costs, fees and postage and packaging was a total of £447.26. With the refund and the negative income from that other jacket, I have a minus of £8.99. All in all, I have a healthy profit of £438.01, and these are my Magpie top 3 finds. So I have 2 pairs of leather riding boots, which I have been able to sell for one of them at £51.75 and another at £42.74 profit, and my Mulberry clutch bag for a profit of £50.94 too. So these are the ones to be on the lookout for. Charity shop and car boot spend totals, also pros and cons. I have spent a total of £133.99 in my local charity shops, and £48.50 at car boot and yard sales. Charity shops, the pros. You're giving money to charity. And the items are already pre-checked for condition. The cons are, they are quite expensive. Car boots and yard sales. Pros, the items are a lot cheaper. Cons, more pressure to make an instant decision regarding price and condition. Did I stick to my objectives? Only visit local town's charity shops and or car boot sales for one outing per week. Yes, I stuck to that. Keep up with the listings and don't hoard. Yes, I stuck to that too. Don't buy any packaging materials except for tape. Recycle packaging from home and also make sure you account for tape and label use in your postage and packaging price. Yep, I stuck to that. On my first eBay sale, invest all profit back into stock to resell and always keep back some profit from future sales to reinvest again. Yep, I stuck to that. Only replenish my stock if I have the money to do so from my eBay profit. This was a bit tricky to stick to because I was just always so eager to go back to the charity shops to see if I could find anything else to flip. But I stuck to that and aimed to flip a profit in all stock within a month of listing on eBay. Yep, I stuck to that too. Buy quality used items in a very good condition with a maximum customer base and items that will be easy to post. Yes, I kind of stuck to this on the whole, but I have made the odd error regarding checking condition and underestimating the size and weight in the postal costs, and this has occasionally negatively hit my profit margin. Always aim to sell your item for times 5 what you paid for it initially. Yes, I have aimed for the times 5 profit sell-through rate on all my listed items. But as I wanted to stick to my flip a profit in an item within a month of listing it, I have been happy to let the item sell through cheaper as long as I am making a profit to enjoy the process of replenishing. Tips and advice. Make sure your designer items are real. Do your research. Don't box shoes away or they will smell. Keep them out and aired until they have sold. Spray shoes with an odour neutralising and antibacterial spray just before packaging. Be mindful of how long items can take to photograph and list. Ultimately, your time is valuable. Consider writing a thank you note to put in with your sold packaged item. This has improved my positive feedback. Where have my items gone to? All UK sales items are not listed internationally. And here we are with a map of the UK and where all my sales have gone to. I am based in Norfolk. Also, here's some lovely positive feedback from my customers. Delivery good, item really good, seller absolutely lovely, sent a lovely note inside our parcel. Great item, as described, thanks, fantastic communication, first class eBayer. Great eBayer, the blazer was, as described, in excellent condition. Well packaged and great delivery, thank you. Item as described, perfect fit, thank you. Nice riding boots, well packaged. First class eBayer, prompt delivery, very pleased, thank you. Thank you for your custom and prompt payment. Enjoy your items and best wishes, Magpie Finds. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If so, give it a thumbs up and I will post another video after I've hopefully sold a lot more items. Thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day.